Once upon a time, there was a boy named Theseus, and his dad put a sword and a pair of sandals under a big rock. And then the mother said to Theseus when he was 7, "I have kept a secret from you a long time. And your father is the king of Athens. And then Theseus said, "Why can't I go to my father now? Why not?" And then the mother said, "There are bad people that wait for you to come. Then if they know you were alive, they would want to kill you." And then Theseus practiced getting stronger and stronger every day. He rode dolphins and chased deer and one day he tried lifting the rock again, but it wouldn't work. Then a seagull came and said, don't fear your opponent's size. Make their strength your strength." And then a big stick came from the ocean. Then he used that stick to lift the big rock, and it worked. And then he got the sword and the sandals. He put the sandals on and bring the sword to his mother. And then he asked, "Whose are these?" And then she said, "It's your mother's. It's your father's." And then she said, "You are ready to go on your adventure." And she said, "Take this boat." And then Theseus said, "No, I want to go on foot and go the hard way." And then a mother said, "Okay." Then he beat many people along the way. He beat up criminals and other bad guys. And then he finally came to King Aegeus, his father. And that day, his father his people had to make a sacrifice. 7 boys and 7 women had to be sent to Crete to King Minos to get eaten by the Minotaur. And then when the 7th boy was going to be called, Theseus said, "No, you can't do this." And then then the father said, "If I don't, then I will go to war with Crete, and then thousands more will die." And then Theseus said, "I will end the life of the Minotaur then." And then King Aegeus said, "Who are you? And why do you think you can beat the unconquerable bull?" And then Theseus showed him the sword. And then Theseus said, "This will show you proof that I'm your son." And then the king said, "You really are my son. Theseus, don't go to Crete, please. The Minotaur will shred you and kill you." But Theseus went on the ship and sailed away. And his father tried to let keep him staying here, staying on King on Athens with the Athens people. And then when he arrived at Crete, at King Minos's place, the huge metal mechanical robot came and took their weapons, and their plan was ruined. And then when they got there, they were put in an arena, and had to fight a ton of bull. And then Theseus said, I will not let my people die like this. And I will fight the white bull. And then King Minos said, oh, okay. But what happens if you lose? Then my people have to fight the bull. And then King Minos said, okay, that's a deal. I will let your people stay alive to watch you suffer. And then Theseus said, that's all I asked for. Then he fought the white bull, and Theseus won. And then they got put in a dungeon where they slept in. And then when they were sleeping, a princess came and said, Theseus, I love you. Come with me on the boat and let's leave my horrible father, King Minos. And one day you can return again. Then Theseus said, no, I will not. What about the other? Then Theseus said, what about the other people? And then the princess said, I can do nothing for them. They will be eaten by the Minotaur, just like you would have been. And then Theseus said, I'm staying here. I kept a promise to my people that I would defeat the Minotaur and set them free. Then she said, no. Then she showed Theseus the mace from above. Then she said, are you brave or are you just a fool? Then Theseus walked away. Then she said, wait. Here's a piece of string. Tie it around the front of the door of the labyrinth. And then, when you do that, tie it around your waist. And then the string will lead you to the Minotaur. Then when you find the Minotaur, kill it, and then follow the string back to the door, and then I will meet you there, okay? Then he said, okay. And then, in the middle of the night, Theseus tied the string around the door, and then he tied it around his waist. And then the string led him to the Minotaur. And then he found the Minotaur. And then the Minotaur was sleeping. But then it woke up. And then he said, come and get me. The Minotaur slammed into a wall. And then after it slammed into the wall, rocks fell from the ceiling, and one really big, huge, sharp rock came and stabbed the Minotaur right in the throat. And then when he And then when he killed the Minotaur, he followed the string back to the door, and then the princess was there. And then they took the other people with him onto the boat, and then the people said, "What about the mechanical giant?" Then he said, "Don't fear opponent's size. Make his strength your strength." And then they threw a huge anchor at the mechanical's robot head, and then they were almost getting out. And then the guards said, "The people escaped, and the Minotaur is dead." Then King Mino said, "Get them ropes or have your head chopped off." And then, when the guard got on the boat to get the people, then the huge mechanical robot fell onto him and his ship sunk. And then Theseus escaped, but then he promised his father that he would put white sails up if he was alive and black sails up if he was dead. And his father was on a high cliff looking out at the Atlantic Ocean.
"My king, Theseus, he returns."
"The ship came."
"What? The ship? The sails are black."
"Forgot that the sails
no.
are black and not white." And then, when his father saw the ship with black sails, he jumped off the cliff to the ocean.
"Because a vision softly creeping,
when Theseus got on land,
left its seeds while
he went to see his father,
sleeping.
But then,
and the vision
he realized
that was planted
he had a black
in
sail.
My brain
and then
still remains.
Then his father was dead
of silence,
because he jumped off the cliff into the ocean. And then Theseus became king, and the princess became queen. They lived happily ever after. The end.